I don't know, I lived here for 21 years. I think my wife married me because of that. You know, so, at the same time, you know, I wanted to, you know, be a good citizen here, be a contributing member of the society. You know, I wanted to change the stereotypes about Arabs and Muslims. People think, we joke about it. I have, American friends. It's like, why are people always so angry? You know, and I say, we're not angry. We're passionate people. and we are passionate. And I wanted to use that passion, to help the community. Here in Louisville, you find out that, if you don't go to the mosque, for example, you really have no community. You have nowhere else to go or no group. And I said, we should create a secular group that will welcome anyone, regardless of your religion. It doesn't matter if you're Christian, Jewish, or Buddhist. We want to help everyone. I created a small group of people that we try to do our best with our limited resources to help, other people. And we co-sponsor the Syrian family. We help Congolese brothers, through KRM, working with KRM. And we try to do with our limited resources to help others and give back to the society, because this society did so much for us. And it's time for us to give back. And I'm so fortunate that we were able to do so. And we're all so grateful that we were able to do so here.
Did you
want to
add anything to that?
He's good. Still try to keep whatever the best of both culture for my family, for my children, and this is not easy. When the children is born here, grown up here, with the peers, and go to school, and now come home with the language that we speak, and we live differently. And we try, it's not easy, even at this point, after 32 years, and here I'm still try to communicate with my children, because they have the American mindset, and they accept it more, even though I share with them how difficult that I came from. They said, you can talk to me 100 times, I remember my heart, but I still cannot have the same feeling with you. But with this country that I learned, communication between the parents, children, it's a two-way communication. It's not like my country is my dad said, you do it. It doesn't matter, right or wrong, just do it. So we don't have that two-way communication. But here, I see the communication between the all the members in the family. That makes the family great. That makes us grow. So I really value the integration. It's a ongoing structure. I'm still have a problem here, but we're still learning and trying every day. Even just now that I have a trip, I visited my daughter, we left a long talk. She said, why do you work so hard? Why do you not spend time with me, like making family? You go out for a movie, do this and do this, whatever the children want, but you always make me study. Make me study. I appreciate you, make you what I am today, but we don't have the quality to come together. So it's hard for a refugee that we live in so many cultures. It's hard for the children, it's hard for the parents like me. So I just want to share that.
That's very true, because I see that with families every day. I didn't understand that from my personal experience, because I've had the same conversation with my father. But it's important that these parents keep a tradition in the family. I really truly appreciate what my dad did. He made sure I understood where I came from. Again, it's very imperative that these refugee children, you know, the foreign-born that will be one day the professionals of the city, keep that, because it's going to truly change, you know, the diversity group here, the population here. And as much as I think immigration is important in terms of employment, in terms of, you know, riding the bus next to a, you know, but when you're home, you know, when you're celebrating a holiday, you should be able to, you know, be who you are. And that's why I think this country is great. It's allowing us to be who we are, but when we're at work, we're like you. We're working, we went to college, our children will go to college, we're going to college. So it's something that I always at least try to say this when I meet, you know, everyone in my line of work. So we do want our client or refugees to integrate. It's a very important process, especially when it comes to employment. But at the same time, it's very important that they keep the culture alive. That's what keeps the city, it's what makes the city so vibrant. And they can go out and buy food from different parts of the world. And we didn't have that before. And I promise you, 20 years ago, we didn't have that here. So we appreciate the culture.
And that's how I would like to end.
Okay.
Because you were talking about the things that popped up in my mind. So as I mentioned, we have a daughter that is now actually 30 years old. She came here when she was, we were here, as I said, for a short period of time. She was very small, and then we came when she was almost six when the war started in the state. And she has been a product of the city 100%. She went to throughout the public school system. It was excellent, I must tell you. Hawthorne Elementary School at the time, and then the Zeke Middle School and Emmanuel High School. She had a fantastic education. Of course, in our culture, education is the most important factor, and to this day, it is the most important factor, especially because of the war, and especially because of the fact that the only thing that cannot be taken away from you is your education. You can lose your home, you can lose your country, you can lose your passport, you can lose everything in life, but if you have education, you will probably be better off anywhere you end up. And that has been proven, a proven fact for me, for my husband, and for our daughter, who is now currently actually, even though she had a great job and everything, she finished Northwestern University, and worked in whatever different companies. Anyway, we made sure that she continues her education and paid for everything, so she's finishing her MBA at Dartmouth, at top at Dartmouth, as we speak. And we, that was, I mean, the one thing that we wanted to make sure that she gets with this. But the point that I want to make is the cultural side was difficult. You know, we speak Bosnian at home, but of course she went to school and she would spend, and I was working full time, my husband was working full time. We would see her only for a limited time during the day, which is in the afternoons, I guess, dinner. Dinner was sacrosanct in our house. I mean, we always had dinner at night, no matter how long hours I worked or my husband or anything. Every night it was dinner, and we had dinner at home. There was a lot of respect. That's the way that we were brought up. We still used to say, this is the way it's going to be done in this household. As long as you're here, there's no questions about it. However, we have changed. And we have adjusted in a way, and she turned out to be a good kid for whatever reason, because she saw so much worse, I guess. Because she was old enough to see how hard it was on other people. We were actually very lucky. I think part of that was in that part anyway, or of her maturity. But the funny story about this is, so we, you know, we kept a lot of our traditions in terms of family values and friends and gatherings and all this kind of stuff while working very hard, doing everything, becoming productive members of this society, 100% integrated, everything. And then, and she speaks fluent Bosnian, even though that part was really hard, because obviously it was so much easier for everybody to speak English once she got home, but we kept to it, and she's good. But the funny part was when she was working for this startup in Boston, and they were really great, and they were hiring a lot, and then they hired another girl from Bosnia. And I was very excited. I said, oh my God, you know, Fatima was her name, I remember very well. But Fatima came to the United States, she was a little bit older,
Emma came when she was less than 6 years old. Fatima came when she was a teenager. So a few months later, I was asking Emma, I said, so how's Fatima doing? And she's like, well, I'm not really sure. And I'm like, why? You know, because of this. She's like, Fatima's just too Bosnian. I'm like, what does that mean? Because I felt totally outraged, you know, she'd say that. I said, and by the way, what does too Bosnian mean anyway? And she's like, well, you know, it's just the way you are. Because, you know, she's on the, you know, she came here early enough to be this, she does have the Bosnian part in her, but she can control it for sure. You know, and she knows how to use it to her advantage. She's like, so I said, what does it mean to be too Bosnian? I was really, offended by my own child. And she said, well, too opinionated, too loud, doesn't allow other people to talk over. I mean, all this stuff is perfectly normal to us. You know? But it made me think. You know, yes, it is great, and thank God for this country that accepts us as we are, too Bosnian or not. But this is what you get. But thankfully, the kids learn, and they adjust better, and then they are better, you know, they can do this better than we do it, basically. But I think we did pretty good, too. Being too Bosnian or not, it's okay.
Yeah. You did more than good. I mean, you've accomplished so much here, and I feel like you've given so much to the city. And that's why it's so important to highlight you guys. And, you know, you're not, there's more than you guys that, you know, obviously have done so much. And we can get everyone to come in. But I want to close off my questions with this last one, and because again, we all chose this city as to be our home. Maybe some of it was not our decision, but we made it our home. I know that was the case for me. I didn't choose to come to a home. I think the city chose me, and for the last 18 years, I've been making plans to move, but that's not happened because I think I truly belong here. And I'm so happy to be able to give back to what was given to me. You know, my journey started at age 12 here, and so ever since then, I've had people help me throughout the way and mentor me and just give me every tool that I needed to be where I am today. But I feel like I've given a lot to the city, and I just want to know, what can we do as a community to increase awareness and mutual respect and appreciation for diversity in the city of Louisville. You know, I think y'all know how much diversity has meant to you and seeing your peers succeed, but how can we raise that awareness, the level of, because there's still more people who are not informed.
If I may, you know, I think the most important aspect of this is that to be an active member of this society, be out there, educate people, talk to people, you know, don't go and just stay in your closed-in circle, you know, expand your circle. You know, I'll tell you from my personal experience, you know, I was on the board with the Crane House with Mr. Kevin Lynch over there, you know, and I, even though, you know, I was not involved with the Asian culture here in Louisville, but I figured Iraq is technically in Asia, so I figured I should be involved with the Asian community as well. And it was a very rewarding experience, you know, being the only Arab who's sitting on the board over there. You know, I actually helped organize the Chinese New Year party for 2 years in a row, and I learned a lot, and we had a lot of fun doing that. But at the same time, from my interaction, I got to, you know, talk to a lot of people, make new friends, and also, you know, help educate people, you know, about the Arab culture. The mayor a few weeks ago had the rally to support immigrants and refugees. Myself and my wife and all of our friends were there. Hale was a speaker over there. She energized people. And they expected, you know, a few hundred people, and over 7,000 people showed up at the rally. So, you know, my I say, you know, be out there, you know, be a good member of the society, and, you know, get your voice out there and do everything you can. Every little thing helps. And, you know, educate, participate, contribute, give back, And, you know,